This conference will now be recorded.
Thank you. Okay, do you have any doubts for the last classes?
No, ma'am.
No,
No.
So we will do together. Like I'll be starting with the formulas, that is the functions that is available, which is available in our Excel. Okay, you can do along with me. If you have anywhere doubts while practicing or doing, please let me know so that I can repeat once again. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Let me share my screen first. Is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Is my screen is visible to everyone? Okay, good.
Yes, ma'am.
So let's work on this. Let me first update the data. Then you can follow me however I'm doing. You can just practice along with me. I need some names, so I'll use here. See, this is a free added here. So in case if you are using any other application, you can go for this add-ins. You will find it in home or insert. You will have an option here as add-ins. Search for autopilot. Autopilot, you will get this option since I've already added. If not, you can also ask for Chat GPT. Okay, Chat GPT 3.5 version. Okay, you can ask any of these things. I'm just using this, but as of now, I don't want to use. I'll directly use the Chrome so that from here I will take the data whatever I want. So I'll take here Chat GPT. I'll ask for some of the names since I don't have want to type again and again the names. So I'll ask here. Give me a list of 20 names. Okay, it gave me. But one more thing, this I need is I want without the serial number. So I take here, provide without serial number. So this names, you can use as much as names you want. I'm just taking this all the 20 names which I need. Copy and I'll paste it here. Let's have this names. So from this names, I'll add the names list. Names, subject one, subject 2, subject 3, subject 4, subject 5, and subject 6. These are the things which I'm using. I'll make this into 100% so that it will be visible for you. Okay, fine, this is enough. So I have given the settings. I'll select this entire data, then give here all borders. I'm not creating a table, I'm just giving a all borders. After adding this, I'm going to take a random values equals to rand between. I'll take the values between 30 comma 90, 30 comma 90. Enter. I have a values here, so I'll extend till vertically as well as horizontally. After taking your names, since this values keeps on changing, I want the value to sustain like that, so constant values. So I'll copy the values from here. Control C, Control Alt V. To paste it as value so that the numbers will not change. So this I have taken. Now we need to make the total. Total, but what we are doing now is we will learn the different methods of addition. Okay, different methods of addition we will do. I'll tell you the few methods which is important, whichever is we will be trying. So those things you can remember and keep taking this. So now I have a total values. For this total values, what I will do is I'll use the first option here. The first option, auto sum. So you have an option here, auto sum. You can just click on this. See, the range has been selected. Then after that, you can press enter. Again, if not this auto sum, you also have the same option in the formula tab here. Okay, see, you have an option here also as auto sum. You can click on this. Even now, the range has been selected. Okay, so first two methods is auto sum. You can either choose from the home tab or from the formula tab. You have the same option, auto sum. The first two things what we have tried is auto sum. Okay, for the third one, I'll use the same auto sum, but I'm going to use a shortcut key. Alt equals to. But see what happens when I am doing for the first time, when I'm doing the calculation for the first time, it has properly selected the range. But second time also it has happened. But when I'm taking the third person's value, it is selecting the total value instead of selecting the values, that is the subject 1 to subject 6. It is taking the total itself. When this happens, you have to select the proper range and then press enter. This I have done. So this is auto sum and shortcut key for auto sum, alt equals to. Alt equals to is a shortcut key for auto sum. You can try this. Try this. I'm giving you 2 minutes. Try this fast. Have you all done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now let's do the next part. Now, see, most of the times the common mistake what people do is when they're making an addition, they'll use plus sign. One or two values it is fine, but when it is multiple signs it is very difficult for us to do. So equals to, I will select this 46 plus 54 plus 54 plus 68 plus 37 plus 47. But what I'm doing is I'm using the cell address, not the value. Okay, now I press enter. See, you got this value. So that is using a plus sign. I'm doing once again equals to. Okay, I will select the cell, then plus, again the second cell, plus third cell, plus fourth cell, plus fifth cell, plus and the last cell. Then I press enter, I got this total. So what we are doing is we are using a plus sign, right? We are using a plus sign. So using plus sign I have done this. Okay, so next one is, instead of using plus sign, we will use a comma. Okay, so Now what I will do equals to, instead of directly starting the formula, see in the previous one, I directly choose the cell. But this time when I'm using a comma, we have to use the function, which is sum. Sum. Okay, so now you can go for the first subject. Subject 1, comma, subject 2, comma, subject 3, comma, subject 4, comma, 5, and then the last subject. Close the bracket and then press enter. So you get this value. Let me repeat once again. Equals to sum. I'll open the bracket. Subject 1, comma, subject 2, comma, then subject 3, comma, subject 4, comma, subject 5, comma, subject 6. Close the bracket and press enter. This is another method of adding the values. Right, I've taken these values, so using comma sign. The next one I'll do here with the range, by selecting range. So what I do here equals to sum. I'll go for the first subject. After selecting to the first subject, hold the sheet and select till the last subject. Hold the shift and select till the last subject. Close the bracket and press enter. Let me repeat the same thing. Equals to sum. Open the bracket. Select from the subject 1 to subject 6 by holding a shift. Close the bracket. Press enter. Okay, this will give you the value. So now we have done three methods. We have done three methods in which you will be doing by selecting a range. By selecting a range, two things by selecting a range have done. Okay, so you can try this using plus, using comma, and using this. So I'll keep this hold. See, I've done this plus sign. Then next one by using a comma sign. Then next one by selecting the range. You can choose whichever you want. Try this. Try this. If you have any doubts or questions, you can ask me. Have you all done?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Priyanka, Neha, Yashika. Good.
Yes, ma'am.
I see. Oh, sorry. Who is this? Jagriti. Jagriti or Jagriti?
Ma'am, Jagriti.
Jagriti. Okay, let's continue. So after this, I'll choose one more method. That method is insert function. You have this option, insert function. You have this option here. So see the dialog box, insert function. Same thing when you go for this formula tab, here also you have insert function. Same thing you'll get. Now what I need to do is addition. For addition, we say it as sum. You just need to search here what you are going to do. If you're getting a list here, directly you can select. But in case if you are searching, type the text what you are searching. After typing, click on this go. Now all the related function to sum you will be getting from here. I'll click on the sum and then okay. So now it says here also you can do in two methods. Okay, by default it is selecting a range. What range it is selecting, we don't know. So let me remove this. Okay, now first thing, you can either select the comma. See, like comma of cell 1, then cell 2, that is this one, then cell 3, 64, then cell next one, subject 5. So subject 5, then next one, again you press tab, you will get this subject 6. So you can see the cross check the values. So I have a values here. First one 77, then it is 64, 49, 63, 58. So where is the other values? 344. It is selecting from the, okay, I didn't select the one more value. So what I will do, I'll just scroll down. Okay, the last value, I will just select one value which is missing. So number 5 is done. After number 5, I'll go for the next one. Number 6. Number 6 is done. Then number 7, I will take this 33. So it is number 7. Okay, that means all the numbers has been taken. Yeah, 33, 77, 64, 49, 63, 58. So all the numbers has been taken. We will click on this. Okay, you got the total. Let me redo once again. So instead of typing anything in a cell, go for this insert function, search for sum, click on this go, you got this total. Now here I will take subject 1, okay, then 2, then we will go for 3, then subject 4, subject 5. Okay, so then next one I'll go for subject 6. Done. See, automatically if you see in this formula bar, if you observe in the formula bar, commas has been added. I'll click on this. Okay, I got the total. The other method is you can just click on this insert function, choose the sum function. Okay, don't need to do any other values, just select the values, that is range, click on OK, you will get this total. So this 3 we are doing through the insert function. It is same thing how we are doing a comma or how we are doing this by selecting a range. That's all. It is just simple as it how we have done in a previous step. Okay, so I'm going to take this the same color, and this is how we have done through the insert function. Insert function. Okay, so this is insert function. Now again, if I do alt equals to, see the total it is taking here, the wrong range. Again, I'm selecting like this. Now what I want to do is I have to show you the commonly used option. Commonly used option, this one. I'm making it bold, auto sum, alt equals to, and selecting range. These are the common things which we will be using. For your understanding, I'll change the font color to dark red. So these are the common method which we will be using. Okay, almost either we will use the auto sum or auto sum shortcut key or by selecting a range. Anything is fine. So I'm going to use here equals to sum. Then I'll go to the first subject. Select all the subjects, subject 1 to subject 5. Close the bracket, enter. And after totaling this one value, you can just double click here. See, when you place your cursor, the cursor will change its symbol. See, the plus sign is changing. When the plus sign changes, you can click and drag like this. Okay, or just keep your cursor here, just press double click on this. So automatically the values will be calculated. So we are using common method, right? Common method of addition. This I'm doing here. So common method I've highlighted with this dark red color. You can use the same thing. Try this. If any doubts, you can let me know.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you repeat the common method?
Once again. Fine. I'll
yes,
repeat
ma'am.
It for
yes.
you. Common method, the one which I have highlighted. See, when I'm doing in a very first cell, all auto sum. Very first cell without any calculation, right? Without any calculation, if I click on this auto sum, the range you can see. By default, subject 1 to subject 6, it has been selected. But the same time, in a middle of the calculation, if somewhere I'm using auto sum, it is not selecting the correct range. In that case, you have to select the proper range. For this auto sum, you have a shortcut key, Alt equals to. I press Alt equals to. Again, the same thing, the range has been selected wrongly. So I'm going to use this by selecting a proper range. By selecting a proper range, I will press Enter, second method. So which is highlighted here, Alt equals to. And the third one is by selecting a range equals to sum, open the bracket, select the subject 1 to subject 6, close the bracket, Enter. So the most of the methods which we will be used is these three methods only, which I've highlighted as auto sum or Alt plus equals to selecting range in a red color. Okay, so the most frequently used method, I can say here as frequently used method.
I don't understand the selecting range one of the functions. Can you repeat that one again?
In selecting a range equals to sum, open the bracket, go to the subject 1. Go to the subject 1, hold a shift key, select till subject 6 by using a arrow key. You have a arrow key, right, left, up, down arrow keys. So I'm using here towards the right, holding a shift key towards the right till the subject 5 and 6. After 6th subject, close the bracket. Then press Enter. Okay, let me repeat it once again. Equals to sum, open the bracket. After opening a bracket, use the arrow keys or you can use a mouse also. Go for the subject 1. Okay, if you are using a keys, after going to subject 1, hold a shift key and the arrow keys, select till the subject 6, close the bracket, press Enter. The next one, if you are using a mouse, equals to sum, open the bracket, click on subject 1, drag till the subject 6, then close the bracket, Enter. Any of these methods you can use. Fine? Nehal? Who asked me?
Yes,
Nehal or
thank
Neha?
You.
Neha. Okay.
Thank
Fine,
you.
Do it, ma. Try this. If any doubts, you can ask me again.
Excuse me, ma'am, can you explain insert function again?
Okay, Priyanka, I'll do it for you. Insert function is similar to your selecting the range option and using a comma function. Most probably, we will be using this selecting a range only. Okay, both the methods I'll show you here. Okay, we'll go for this insert function. Search for sum. Then click on this, go. Once you click on this go, you will get this option. I'll click on this. Okay, I got this. Now, it's showing you the range, right? It shows you the range. So you can select here subject 1, then number 2, subject 2, number 3, subject 3, then number 4, subject 4, right? Then number 5, it is subject 5, then the last number, you can use this down arrow key. Last number, subject 5 is over, subject 6 value. Then click on this OK. See here itself, it says you the numbers. You can cross check here itself. So the first number is 75, second number is 59. So you can see this 20, Evelyn. Okay. So this column you're seeing here. This column you're seeing here. So number 5. Okay, so see here 75, okay, then 59, 68, 73, 55. After 55, you have a 58. All the values has been selected. click on this, okay, here also it will show you the total directly. Same total you will get it here, 388. Or in the same insert function, you can also use this. I'm going to use sum function. Click on go and then okay. Now remove this. So see, I'm selecting from 69, that is from 69 till the 31 I will select. So see the marks here, 69, 54, 45, 44, 64 and 31. The exact same numbers I'm having here also. Now after selecting this, click on OK, you will get the total. Got this?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Fine. So now let's proceed with the next step. Okay. This time again, I'll use the same names and the marks. I'll select this. So we are going to do the other problem. So I'll put it here. This is also an addition only we are doing it. But we will be using a different calculation along with addition. So I'm putting here the total. I need to find the total value. So alt equals to enter. So one total I got it. I can just double click here. Or I'll use equals to sum. Open the bracket from subject 1 to subject 6. Close the bracket. Enter. Then let me extend this till the last value. So I got this total. I got this total. Okay, you can try this. Next one, I'll proceed with the next one. Finish this. Have you all done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we'll do the next one. Now, see, we have Emma. Emma has scored from subject 1 to subject 6. This is the score. Now, I want to know in this, which is the lowest score of Emma? Lowest score, which one I want to know? So, we have 53, 54, 68, 66, 61, 55. So among this, the lowest one is 53. I can see this and tell you. And second one, I have a lime. So in that, she has scored here 89, 89, 88, 37, 35, 45. So 35 is the lowest. Now, the same thing I need to find for every student. Every student, what is the lowest mark? So let's take it here as lowest score. For this, we have to use a function equals to min, minimum, min. Okay, what it says, returns the smallest number in set of the value. So, in set of range, what we are going to select. And it will ignore if there is any logical value or any text like absent or if it is like fail or any other things. Those things it will ignore. I'm taking here minimum. Open the bracket. M-I-N, min. Open the bracket. From subject 1, select till subject 6. Close the bracket. Enter. Again, I'm doing the same thing. Equals to sum. From the subject 1, I'll select till the subject 6. Then close the bracket, press enter. Okay, I scored the, I have taken this also. I have to take here minimum score. So equals to minimum. Open the bracket. So after opening a bracket, you can select from subject 1 to subject 6. Close the bracket and press enter. You will come to know the lowest marks. Okay, I'm repeating again, equals to minimum, open the bracket, from subject 1, select till the subject 6, close the bracket, then press enter, you will get the lowest score. So let's explain this, all the marks we have getting here. We are getting all the marks here. Okay, you can see whoever has scored the less mark. Okay, so find this, find the value. Try to do this. Okay. Any doubts in this? Have you tried it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we will find the highest score. Okay, highest score. So same here also, it will ignore if there is somewhere absent. So what we will do equals to maximum. For lowest one, it is minimum, min. For highest value, it is max, maximum. Open the bracket, equals to max, open the bracket. Select the range, that is from subject 1 to subject 6. Close the bracket, enter. I'm repeating again, equals to max, open the bracket, select the subject from subject 1 to subject 6, close the bracket, enter. You will get the highest score from all the subjects. Okay, so you can try this. Have you all done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next step, we will find the average value of this. So, average value. Or you can say average score. See, till now,
ma'am, maybe I... Ma'am, right?
Yeah.
The screen is not showing.
Sorry, ma'am.
Ma'am, the screen is not being shown.
I'm sharing it again. Is it done now?
Yes, ma'am.
So average score we have to see equals to, for minimum min, for maximum it is max, but for average we don't have a short form. We have to type the entire spellings average. We have to type entire spelling equals to average. Select from subject 1 to subject 6. Close the bracket, then press enter. Same thing I'm repeating again. Equals to average. Select from subject 1 to subject 6, close the bracket, enter. So you got this average value. You can expand this. Since I have many decimal values, I want to reduce the decimal values to 2. You have this option, see, this numbering format. You have an option here as decrease decimals. You can click on this to decrease into 2 decimal values or 1 decimal values. So what I want to do is, I'll select from the beginning, from the first cell. So decrease or increase to 2 points. It is your wish. 2 points let it be. I'll keep like this. Okay. Average score. I'm repeating this again. Okay. Equals to average. I'm selecting from subject 1 to subject 6. Close the bracket. Enter. I'm repeating again. Equals to average, open the bracket, select the subject 1 to subject 6, close the bracket and then press enter. Now I'll extend this value calculation till the last cell of my values. Select from the first cell till the last range. I need the decimal values, only 2 decimal values. So in this numbering format, if you see here, in this numbering format, you have here as decrease decimal. So I will decrease it to 2 decimals. So you can try this. I've selected from subject to 1 decimals and keep this to subject 6. Try this by doing it. Try doing this. If any doubts, you can ask me.
Excuse me, ma'am. How to reduce it to 2 decimal, ma'am?
Look here. You have an option here. This number format. Can you see a number format? This one. Can you see my cursor?
Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Under home tab, you have an option as number group. Number group. Here you have a increase decimal, decrease decimals.
Yes, ma'am.
So how much you want, that much you can increase or decrease.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Any other doubts? Okay, I'm using another function. I'll paste the names here. Now let me give a age. I'm just giving the age here, age option. Let the age be anything. You can give any values. So I am giving manually because I need some changes to be done. So I'm using here. Or you can use rand also, equals to rand between 10 comma 50, close the bracket, enter. I'm not sure where and all I'll get less than 10. So none of the places. This is fine. Here let me change it to 50. Control C, Control All T. Let me paste it as values. 39, 33, fine. 5 years. Let me give you 12 years. 47, 31, fine. 12, 11, fine. 20. Okay. Some values have given. I have an age, list of age. This is fine. If you give the same age as what I have given, might be you will get the same answer what I'm getting. Okay, but let me first show what is my requirement. So we have done all the mathematical calculation, addition, subtraction. I mean subtraction, multiplication. I've not yet started. I have here total, that is high total value, lowest value, highest value, and the average value. This we have done. Okay. Now, what I want to do is, I want to apply the result. For the result, I'm teaching you one option. So, say example, I'll be giving here, my requirement is, you all know what is the rights for voting, right? Voting rights. So, I'll give here as eligible. Eligibility. Now, I want to know here, voting rights. Okay. So, what is the voting rights age? Sorry? Sorry, Supriya, what, ma?
Ma'am, your screen is lagging a bit.
Neha?
So we cannot follow. Your screen is lagging a bit, so we cannot follow.
Okay, I'll be a bit slow also. My question was, what is the age limit for voting? If you have to vote, voting rights you have, right? Voting rights, age limit. What is the age limit is my question.
18, ma'am.
At what age you can, you all can vote?
18, ma'am.
Exactly. So the voting rights is 18. So if your age is, if your age is greater than, right, if it is greater than or equals to 18, then you have, you can vote. If it is less than 18, why I said equals to 18? Because even the 18 age can vote it. So not, no vote rights, no voting rights, right? If a person is having an age limit 18 years, even 18 years is included, so I'm saying equals to 18. And a person, if he is more than 18 also, he can vote. So which means a person's age when he is more than 18 and also 18, he can vote it. If he is having a less than 18, then which means he cannot vote. This is what is my requirement. So what I do here is equals to, just a second. Okay, since there is a screen is getting frequently disconnect for disconnection for you, so let me change my network. Please be online. Okay, stay online. Is my screen visible now? Girls?
Yes, ma'am.
So let's continue here. If you have any questions, let me know. Okay. So what I want an output. I need an output. If this person's age is 18 and above, I have to get an output saying that eligible. If the person is having the age less than 18, I have to get an output saying that as not eligible. So this is what is my required output here. If the age is greater than 18, I need it as eligible. If the age is less than 18, I need it as not eligible. So for this, what we do is equals to, right? Equals to if. We are using if function. If, so what does this if do? It will check whatever the condition we are applying. If that condition is met, my requirement, if it is meeting my requirement, that means it is accepting my requirement. If it is positive, then it will give you value as true. That means if the age, if the condition for what I'm defining, if it is accepting it, it will give me one output, so which is going to be a value if it is true, eligible. If it is not matching my requirement, then it will give you the false value, which is going to be a not eligible. So I say here equals to if, open the bracket, logical test based on what my condition is applied. I select this age. Okay, I'm selecting this age. Now, after this age, I say that if this age is greater than or equals to 18 years, if the selected cell age is greater than or less, that is equals to 18, comma. So you can see in syntax also, it says comma, logical text, comma. Then what I need here is, I need another output, which is going to be your value if it is true. Okay. So what I need here is, I'm going to say what is my requirement. I'll open a double quote. I will say here as eligible. So if the condition is matching, I need it as eligible. That is what is my condition I've given. Greater than or equals to 18 is eligible. Eligible. I'll close the double quote. Give a comma. Now value if it is false. If the given condition is false, what output I need? I need it as not eligible. Then I'll close this bracket. Close the double quote, close the bracket. Whenever you are typing anything in your text, that is a letters or letters and number combination, any symbols, then it has to be given within a double quotation, inverted commas, or else it will be considered, it will be giving you a error values. Okay, so it says eligible. Let me change the age here. I'll change to 5, which is not eligible. I'll change to 10. Not eligible. Let me change here 17. Not eligible. I'll give here 11 months. Not eligible. If I give here as 18, now it says eligible. Whenever the age is greater than or equals to 18, only then it is eligible. If not, it is not eligible. Let's try once again. Equals to if open a bracket, select the cell of age, what it has. If the selected cell age is greater than or equals to 18 years, 18, comma, open a double inverted comma, say it as eligible because I need an output saying it as eligible. Close the double quote, value if it is true is done, give a comma. If this condition is not matching, I need an output saying as not eligible. Open a double quote, type it as not eligible. After typing this, I'll close the double quote, close the bracket, then I press enter. Now see, I got an output. So this, whatever my requirement was, based on that, it will be showing me the output. So this was my requirement. Based on this requirement, I got a output. This is my heading, so I'll just color it. Okay, so now you can try this. If any doubts, you can let me know. Then, have you all tried this? Do you have any doubts?
No, ma'am, no doubts.
Good then. Then I am giving you this task. You try this. Okay. So here in the previous problem where we have found the minimum value, maximum value, highest value, I'm just going to have another calculation here saying that the result, we need a result, right? So for the result, I'll give you the condition here saying that the passing mark. Okay. Passing mark is 35. The passing mark is 35. So what is my requirement in this passing mark? If anyone in any subject, so this passing mark is not for one subject, in all the subject, in all the subject, in all the subject, if the score, okay, is more than 35, greater than or equals to 35, okay, then I need an output saying that as pass. I need a result saying that as pass. So that means here the passing mark is 35. So if this condition is matching, I need an output saying it as pass. If not, okay, so pass after pass, if the score in any one subject, in any one subject is also less than 35, then I must get an output saying that as fail. This is the one. So that means the passing mark. So age limit was 18. So passing mark limit here is I'm giving 35. So this is your task. I'm giving you 3 minutes. You can finish this and tell me what is the output you will be getting. Try this. I've given you the condition. You can try this the same as the if condition what we have done for the age limit. Aditi, Supriya, do you want to say something? Have you all tried? Do you have any doubts? Anybody has tried? Who has got an output?
Yes, ma'am, got an output.
Okay. Nihil, tell me how you have done. I'll do the same thing what you have done now.
So I did is equal to if.
Mm-hmm.
Then I selected the average score more than equal to 35, comma, in double quotes, pass. Sorry.
Okay, see, the average score is what? It is overall score.
Okay.
Average is the overall score. Listen now. So I'll tell you this, how this average score will come. So this is a total subject, right? Total subject for the 357. So overall subject that is equals to 357 divided by 6 subject. You can take it as 600 also. So it is 59.5. So this is overall score. So which means you should not use average score.
You okay, have to ma'am. Use so we should use percentage.
Not at all. You have to know which is the lowest mark. So we have your lowest marks, no minimum.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
If any subject, in any one subject also 35, if it is less, then it is fail only, right? So we will come to know from the lowest score itself. So we will select lowest score. If this is greater than or equals to
35. Okay.
Yes, comma. Then open a double quote, give it as pass, close a double quote, give a comma. If not, it is going to be a fail. So give it in a double quotation, then close the bracket, enter. So any subject here, wherever there is a less than 35, it will show you as fail. See here. 34, fail. 30, fail. 33, fail. 32, fail. So here, fail. Here also, fail. So wherever, see exactly 35. Do we have anywhere exactly 35? Yeah, this one. The second person exactly 35, that means equals to 35, which means he is passed. You will get the result. Understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
So fine. Now we will do some more problems. So let's take here. Okay, so and one more thing, I want to insert the values, how much they have scored. So here I have a total, right? I want to insert a chart within a cell. Within a cell, if I want to insert a chart, what I will do is, I'll go for insert. Okay, you have this path line. So which type of chart you want, that you can select. Suppose if I want line, I'm showing you all the three. Line, I get this data range. From subject 1 to subject 6, I will select. Then I'll click on this. Okay, I got this line chart. I'm showing you all the three type of charts. Okay, so this I'm doing. So let me take this cut and I'll put it here. So line chart is done here. The same thing I'll show you with the other one. Insert column chart. Column chart. I'll select subject 1 to subject 6. I'll click on this OK. So this will show you the column chart within a cell, highest to lowest. Then the next one, I have a win or loss. Insert win or loss, I will select. This will look like similar when I'm selecting this data range, but when it is different, this I will show you. Yama,
ma'am, we can't say what you're doing, like it's larger a bit, so we can understand.
Is it still lagging?
Yeah. Ma'am, can you repeat the line chart?
I'll show you once again. Okay. Let me do it in a separate place. Okay, so take it here. Let me do it in a different place. I'm just taking here from January. To December, I will take. Twelve months. I'll give your months. Then we will take it here. Store A, store B, store C, store B, and store E. Five stores we have. So there is like equals to rand, rand between 0 to 10. I will give, close the bracket, enter. I have to use rand between 0 to 10. I'm giving the values. So I'll expand this. I'll say take here control C, control alt V, take it as values. So this is like, let's consider there are new scheme. In each and every month, how many new schemes they have taken? Okay, so new scheme introduced by store in every month. So what I want here is, I want to know in each and every month how many new score. For this, I'm going to insert a chart, line chart. Okay, click on the cell where you want to insert the chart. I'm doing slowly. I'm clicking here. I'll click on the spark line. Insert spark line line. It says data range from store A, B, C, D, E. I'm selecting entire thing. Is it visible? Girls?
No, ma'am.
Which screen are you getting now?
My screen is visible, but when you're seeing it, it's not showing at the same time. It's showing a little bit later.
Okay, I'm repeating once again. So I'm not changing the screen. I'll just show you. You have to go for insert. You have to go for insert. The place where you need a line chart, just place your cell there. So I am placing here in the next to E store. Then I'll go to this insert. You have an option under spark line, line. Click on this line. You will get this dialog box opened here. The dialog box will open. Create spark line, data range. So I need a line chart to be created for the month of January for all the stores, right? For A, B, C, D, E, all the stores. So I'm selecting all the range, right? From store A to store E, I have selected. Now you have to click on OK. As soon as you click on OK, you will get this line chart. Can you see this line chart created?
Yes, ma'am.
Now you can extend this to this level. Same thing, you have to repeat it when you are doing for column chart also, the same thing. Only thing is, you will go for insert. Again, go for this insert sparkline. You will find an option as column. Click on that column. It will again ask you the data range. Select the same data range from store A to store E. Okay, you need to select the same thing from store A to store E. Then after that, click on OK. You will find this column. You will find the values column. Okay, now see here, I have a zero, so you cannot see the any chart here. But when you do it in win or loss, the same again, insert, I'm going to insert. In the insert, I have an option as win or loss. I'll click on this. Again, it is asking me the data range. I'm selecting from store A to store E. Then click on this OK and I will drag this. See, here also it is same thing, but it's not showing you the chart. It is not showing you the chart. It is just showing the same level of boxes with blank space wherever there is a zero level, that is zero scheme introduced. Clear? Do you all get this point?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, are you saying something? I can't hear you.
So let me tell you what I'm doing. I have a values here. So I'm taking here values from 80 to 120. So what I have done is I have taken a product name. Product name, I have a list of product names here. Okay, I have a list of product names. So opening stock, at present I have this opening stock, then inward, which means a purchase. So I have the details, how much I made a purchase, and outward, how much sales I made. So for this inward, that is opening stock, I've used a function ran between 50 to 100. Then for inward function, that is inward function purchase. So purchase value, I made it the ran between 40 to 80. Then I have a sales here. From the sales, I have here total value 80 to 120. 80 to 120. Now I need to find the closing stock. We are going to find out reorder status. I will tell you what is reorder status later. Now first we need to find the closing stock. Closing stock. So I'll select this all borders. Then after giving all borders, for the heading, I'll give a color. Yeah. So I want to find the closing stock. So closing stock equals to opening stock plus purchase minus closing stock, you will get the value. So here it is a negative sales. That means somewhere we have made a less sales. So I'll change the value here to 100. Okay. So I'll just extract this. So this is a sales we have. This is a sale. So what did I do? Opening stock plus purchase minus sales. Opening stock plus purchase minus stock. I have got this closing stock. In this closing stock, what is my requirement is? Okay. If the closing stock, you will be working on this. If the closing stock is less than 20, you have to show me an output. Okay, it must display as reorder. It has to display as reorder. And in case if the closing stock is greater than 20, I have to get an output. So it has to display as stock in hand. It has to display as stock in hand. This is my requirement. This is my requirement in a reorder status. So you tell me how I have to apply the function. I will do according to you. Whoever wants to say can say me this. I told you my condition. My condition is if the stock is less than 20, it has to display as reorder. If it is greater than 20, it has to display as stock in hand. Who wants to say this? How I have to apply the function? Anybody? Just have a try. Nehal, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you want to try?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Tell me how you want to do. I'll do according to your instructions.
Okay, ma'am. So, firstly, is equal to if, and
yes.
We'll choose the closing stock.
Good.
Then that will be, we'll put less than 20 and comma in brackets, we'll write reorder and then
it's a double quote.
Yes, sorry, double quotes. we'll write reorder and then comma, and in double quotes we'll write next we'll write stock in hand and then bracket closed.
Very good. So here I get this reorder because it is less than 20. Got it. Now one more requirement. I want to highlight reorder in a red color. All the reorder option I want to highlight in red color. Tell me now how I have to do. Any questions, any doubts, you ask me. If not, tell me. Like we have already done highlighting the values and all. Who will try this time? Jagriti, would you like to try?
Sure, ma'am.
Tell me, ma.
Ma'am, for the second one, right?
No. I have this list, no? Reorder and stock in hand. In this,
yes, ma'am.
Only reorder level, reorder option, I want to highlight in red color.
Yes, ma'am, I can't see your screen properly.
Is it not that much visible? Who can see my screen and who want to try this other than Jagriti? Anybody else? No one? Should I pick you? Aditi? You want to give a try? What about Kushbu? See, I'm picking only the one who is keep responding me. Priyanka? Fine then. So I think you all forgot this conditional formatting. Conditional formatting, highlight the cell rule, text that contains what? Reorder. You have an option, reorder. As soon as you give a text, you can choose a color. I said red color, click on OK, so reorder. It has been highlighted. Suppose if I change a value here, 50 I'm having. So this 50 and 89 is a stock, it says close. Outward I made a sales, so 33. Let me make it here as 95. Now 27, so I'll make it here as 100. Then again, I'll make it here as 105. So reorder, see, it's changing. Anytime the values keep changing, you will be getting an output by default how the values has been changed. So in case somewhere if you want to highlight those values, you can do it. So I'll suggest you to try the same option here. So eligible in one color or not eligible in one color, if you want to highlight, you can use this. And again, we have a result here. Fail, you can highlight it. Whoever has failed, that you can highlight this. Clear? You can try all these things. If you want to highlight the failed one, if you want to highlight the eligible, not eligible one, you can use this highlighting option however you want. I have just shown you one option by using this reorder. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Try all these things. If any questions or any doubts, you can ask me in next class. Okay. So as of now, for today's, this is what we are doing it. You can practice everything till today, whatever we have done. Ask me if you have any questions in the next class. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Fine. Can we wind up the session for today?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. See you in tomorrow's session. Bye, everyone.
Thank you.